In a previous video, I explained how to make a starry background like this in After Effects, but I thought, what the heck? Let's make it in the Fusion tab of DaVinci Resolve. When you're finally done, your node tree is gonna look something like this. It's not too complicated, but we're gonna build it step by step. All right, the first thing we're gonna need is a background, which is this bad boy over here. Now, if I connect that to media out, you can see that it is a black background. Nothing too crazy. What we're gonna need next is some stars. If we're gonna make a starry background, it better have some stars, right? And that's where this little effect comes into play. This is fast noise. Now you notice it's got a lot of options. What we want are the noise settings and the color settings. If I click left, you can see the fast noise effect is now on the left viewer. This is very splotchy. It's not exactly star-like. We want a bunch of little dots, which means we're gonna need to adjust the noise settings over here in the inspector panel. We're gonna increase the detail up to maybe 4-ish. I like round numbers, so I'm gonna just type in 4. I'm gonna turn down the contrast a smidge. I'm gonna turn down the brightness, let's say, I don't know, 0.5, maybe a little more, 0.7. Okay, so still splotchy, but you can now actually like really see through the gaps. That's all we've done so far is we've made some gaps for the black background to show through. The bottom half of these noise settings are really where the magic happens. So if we turn this up, you can see that the pattern gets smaller and smaller and smaller. We're basically zooming out, but the slider only goes up to 20, right? It goes from 0 up to 20. Now that doesn't mean you are limited to 20. You can always just type in a number, let's say 150. Now we're starting to get to something that looks a little more like stars. It's a little too dense, but it's a bunch of little dots. We also have a problem here where if you hit play and the timeline continues, nothing's actually happening there, and we would like these stars to twinkle. Stars tend to twinkle when we look at them through the atmosphere. And so I can increase this seethe rate here. Let's go with 0.05. So if we change that to 0.05, and then you can see the stars actually move around. But they still don't quite look like stars. It just kind of looks like noise. This is a fast noise effect. It's gonna look like noise unless we tweak the settings just right. So we're gonna pop over here to the color tab. Right now it's set to 2-color. We've got a transparent one. The alpha's all the way down. If I turn that all the way up to black, you can see that the gaps in between are now just black. And then we've got the white color. These are the white stars. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually switch this to gradient. And I'm gonna bring our gradient way into the center. Something like this. And so you can see if as we bring these in, we're starting to get something that looks a lot more like stars. I've increased the gap in between the two things. Now, of course, you might be thinking, Nick, it's already white stars on a black background. Why do we need that background node? It's gonna be important later. We're gonna want it in there. Now, I guess if this was all you needed, then so be it. But if we wanna make this look a little fancier, we're gonna want that background node in there. Next, we wanna get these together so that they're both going to media out and we can see them both together over here. So what we're gonna want is a merge node, and that is this baby right here. So I'm gonna bring this down and you'll see it glow blue. I'm gonna let go. I wanna make sure my background is on the background input. And then I'm gonna bring my fast noise into the foreground input. It's still the same black background over there, but if I come in and I bring this alpha, this sort of opacity down, right? I'm taking the black and I'm making it transparent instead. You can see that there's a bunch of white stars here on a transparent background. So now the black in the right viewer, the total view, the media out, the black here is from the background, not from the fast noise, and that's very important. The background has other settings we're gonna take advantage of. If we take a look at the background settings, you can see the type defaults to solid color, but if we switch this to 4-corner, we can actually put 4 different colors in here if we wanted to. We're only gonna put 2, but we can put 4. So right now we got a top left, which I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna change to like blue. It's nice solid blue is 240. And you can see the upper left corner is blue. Now it's a little too bright. I wanna bring that down a little bit. You can turn the blue down with this single blue dial right here, but I like to type in numbers. So I'm gonna go 0.1. It's just a subtle blue accent in the corner. And I'm gonna do the same thing down here in the bottom right. I'm gonna make this blue 0.1. And so we're gonna put a little blue accent there. This isn't something you'd be able to do if we were just using the fast noise node. Now this isn't quite as pretty as I'd like. It would be nicer if we had some kind of like nebulous cloud in here. So we're gonna need a few more nodes. This is gonna be the fanciest part of the node tree, but it's not that complicated. So the first thing we're gonna wanna decide is the color of the cloud. And we're gonna do that with a background node. I'm gonna go ahead and put it on the left viewer so we can play around with that now that we're done with the fast noise. I'm gonna come in here and pick a color. I'm a fan of magenta, something like this. And you'll notice that it doesn't look very cloudy, doesn't look very nebulous, but it's because we're not done with it yet. We're gonna wanna mask this out so that it has a cloud shape. If you look down here at the background node, you'll see that there's this blue thing, and if I hover over it, you can see it's effect mask. It's gonna tell us what to include and what not to include from it. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna bring in this polygon so I can draw whatever shape I want. And now this defaults to being animated. You can see right there, there's a keyframe. I'm gonna go ahead and remove that because I'm not gonna animate this thing. My cloud is gonna be stationary. If you want your cloud to move, that's fine. Just leave it on there and you can change the shape at various points along the timeline. But I'm going to draw a shape here and I can move these around later. And so if I link this to the mask, you can see now that only that part is showing through. Only that part's added. You can see these sharp corners are not great. So if I highlight all of these points and I say smooth, you can see they all become curved, which is much more cloud-esque than what we had before. I'm gonna take these points and move them off the screen, but I can play around with these. Still not exactly cloud-esque, right? We would like this to be a little see-through, a little blurry. And so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pass this through a blur node. And so that's this bad boy right here. Bring this down. We're gonna go ahead and take this background. And so if you click that there, now these two things are linked. You can't see the line, but if I stretch it out, there it is. Now I'm gonna move my left viewer down here. And you see it blurs a little bit. The blur size is only one. We're gonna make it much more dramatic than this. So if you increase the blur size, you can see it gets blurrier like so. We're gonna make that 75. Something like that. And that looks a little more wispy. It's not quite as see-through as I would like, but it makes it more cloud-like. Now we're going to need to merge this with the rest of the stuff. And so we're gonna need another merge node. You'll now see it in the overall view. But again, it should really be a little more see-through than this. You're gonna look at these things, you're gonna be like, oh no, where's my opacity settings? I mean, I guess I could do it here, but the best place to do it is actually in the merge node. So if I go to merge and I select blend and I turn that down, what I'm doing is I'm telling Fusion to say, okay, well, this is my foreground. This nebulous cloud is my foreground, but don't go hard on it. Go a little easier. So if I say 0.5. This merge node is now told to take this really bright purple foreground cloud and just only press it into the background like half, 0.5. And so you can kind of just control how bright you want that nebulous cloud to be. Maybe 0.25 looks pretty good. And you get something that looks like this, which is a really nice starry background. And if I come back here and I hit play, you can see the stars twinkle a little bit. If you want them to twinkle a little faster, you just come back over to the fast noise and you adjust the seethe rate. If you make that higher, then you can see the stars twinkle like crazy. It's not really what stars do. So I tried to go a little more subtle with it, but you can play with the settings. This is, you know, take your artistic freedom. But there you have it. We have a starry background. I think this looks pretty good. Hopefully that helped, and let us know what we should animate next in the comments. Thanks for watching.